game started. That is the equivalent of truffles for a horse. And the cows, ever present, this farming school is self-sufficient. And Trevorton College, established in 1964, and 500 years of combined experience among the staff. I can tell you that it is set on the most spectacular grounds. They've got zebra and blessbuck and all number of beasts, not the domesticated kind that you find here at Weston. And Weston, it was established in the first year of the First World War. Paul Tate, I met the headmaster just before the game. He was looking a little nervous, and perhaps with good reason. Second half is underway. It's Weston in the stripes, playing from right to left on your screens. And there's an error from Trevorton, allowing that ball to go over the head.
I think, again, just maybe got to do a little bit with that breeze. It comes and goes, and it might just help or not help with the judgment of the ball.
So Trevorton in the white, playing from left to right now, and a good win from Keegan Taylor in the line for them. Francois Bass, he's looked to have a snappy service at scrum half, and Richardson, we've seen he's got a long and effective boot. That's good play from Wandile and Kambule, and the referee's going to have a word here.
Good number. That's number.
Dangerous play.
Listen, you can't hit the guy late. Leave him alone and play the ball.
So far, I've been very impressed with Brandon Slow. His fielding of the ball and the high balls in the back, even with the wind. He's pretty solid, haven't knocked one ball. And he's got a very good eye for the gap on the counter-attack.
Marco Murray, who was lectured. He's a big lad on the wing, 84 kilos. This one comes back to Untumbela. Bauer running onto the ball at pace that time. Good tackle coming in from the flying Stuart Shaw. Still chances here. Slow up from fullback. Untumbela digs it out. This is more the kind of rugby that the Western locals understand.
Go hands.
Keeping it amongst those big forwards for a little while longer. Now into the path of Bauer. This is Liversidge. Good step from him. Good handoff. Lovely little Sonny Bill. Bauer going for the corner. Bauer's in. Now Weston have their first try. Love
that. That all started with a bit of play from the side. And as they were doing it, I was looking and I was thinking to myself, this is a planned move.
Just keep those tackles
to the midfield. They had one more go to the sideline. And then they put those big guys up in the middle. Kyle Mustard, the lock, came in. They played through about six or seven phases. And a wonderful step just to put Michael Bow away. And you're not going to stop that big man from that close from the line.
So the perfect start to the second half for Weston. And this kick is to level the scores. I can tell you that Michael Bower's uncle is here and watching. He's standing on the bales below us at the moment. His business is moving cattle around, and he'll have his hands full next week getting all the cattle down to the Royal Show. That's a good looking kick. That's a perfect kick, and it's tied up at 10 each in this FNB Classic Clash.
All 7 points from Michael Dark. Try and the kick over the poles. And that was a fantastic little offload behind the back, and Michael Bauer over the line.
You mentioned in the first half, AJ, that it looked as if Bauer and Liversidge had played a lot of rugby together, and that was an example of it.
Absolutely. You would imagine the boys have played a bit of touch rugby in the week for 5 years in a row now.
Marks here, guys. Marks here.
Trevorton back on Marks the attack here, with that knock on.
Hey, come. Hey, Robson. Dup. What's the call? Dup.
Weston, they've got the advantage now of having that breeze from behind, and it's a little bit across the field, but yet from the back, and they could use that with their kicks to play in Trevorton's half.
Big shove from the Western boys, back from base to Richardson. That looked as if it may have gone forward. Referee was on the spot though, and he says play on. In fact, it's a penalty to Western.
Holding on. Always nice when you've got a big tackle like that, and something happens, and you get a turnover, you get the penalty, and now the boys have got their tails in the air.
Now Bauer, with the wind behind him, he's gained a few meters, but that is not in touch. It's taken by Tilbury. Tilbury does well to link with his left wing, Hennick. Now here's Francois Bass. It was well taken above his head by James Muller.
Whoa, Blue! Step, yeah, Blue, step!
Driven on by Pickering.
All the forwards offside.
Hey, number two.
So penalty goes the way forwards of Trevorton. I mentioned the name of Tristan Pickering, who was the number one in the middle of your screen there. Now he, if I'm not mistaken, is related to a Springbok. Can you guess who?
I'm not happy when you put me on the spot like this.
Well, he went forwards to Michael Hanks.
Blue forwards. You have to work
that
hard
to help players. That cuts it down to two, doesn't it? I'm going to keep you in suspense for a little bit longer there.
Won't be able to focus on the commentating though.
Strew and Carey finding Gumedi at the tail of the line. Pickering takes it up to the 22. Turnover ball. Here's Bauer. Nice work from him.
Leave it.
And that ball is in touch.
If I was the guy from Western, I would not even waste time playing in 9:22 at this moment. They've got the wind. Play down in their half, let them make the mistakes.
Not straight. Options.
And yet they get another opportunity, so let's see if they use my advice.
Wonderful atmosphere. There's the colours of Western. Down below us, and on the far side where the camera's picking them up now, those are the pupils from Trevorton.
Cross!
Don't worry about that noise in your head, in your TV. That was my commentary sheet hitting the microphone at pace. The wind has got up again. There's a bit of branding for you. That's not Western branding, that's our sponsor. Lineouts have been a little bit of a lottery. That didn't travel far.
Go five. Not five.
Bauer. Good stepping from him. Back on the inside to Ntombela. This is good play from Western. Lovely strong running there from Dubay. He's got it to within 15 meters. This is a new Western side with the wind at their backs in this second half. And they've got the advantage, they'll have the penalty.
We spoke about hard tackles and dangerous tackles. It's enough.
Oh, and it's a yellow card. That's a big moment in the game. Referee has been speaking about tackles in particular, and it's the second time that Marco Murray has run foul of the referee, and this time he's off with the yellow card.
You're 100% right, Andy. That could swing this game really the other way. I mean, if they could keep pressure in the next 10 minutes, while he's off.
No, why not?
And I've been watching that Sabalo Dube.
Okay.
It's a big boy, and he looks like he's got a lot of pace. Wonderful to watch the big guy run like that.
Okay, Marco, it's fine now, yeah.
Yes, he's 98 kilos, 1.83 meters, which is big for a schoolboy.
A few basics there when you run. You got to always have the ball on the outside from where your defender is coming from. And Sabalo was just making a small mistake there. He could have handed him off.
There's a lonely spot for Marco Murray. He's at the other end of the ground, on his own, next to the upright. This is for the lead. Michael Bauer, the captain of Weston. Hoofs it towards the Centenary Pavilion, and Weston are in front for the first time.
This will be a big test for Trevorton if they can handle the next 10 minutes with 14 men.
The restart from Richardson. Just a rumble too far for the big fella Kyle Mustard there. Kyle Mustard. He's 103 kilos.
Leave it blue.
Basted well to recover from there. Tilbury is brought down. Good tackle.
Leave it.
From Livesic. Leave it. Now it's driven up by Stuart Shaw. And the referee was playing advantage, so he'll bring them back.
Forward pass, we're going back for an offside.
Now, this could be an opportunity for Trevorton to aim at goal.
Going to the bin.
Oh, and there's a stern warning there.
Okay.
There's a definite battle between Luke Richardson and Michael Bauer. I've seen one or two little tackles, you know, the guys have been sizing each other up. And both of them good players, both good kickers. But they definitely have got an eye for each other in this game.
Now, we've mentioned the wind, and even though this is just outside the 22, the decision is to set the line out. That was a forward pass from Pickering.
Yeah. Okay.
And you've had time to think about it now.
Oh, I still don't have it.
Patrick Sillieres, his mother was a Pickering.
Patrick Sillieres, just got engaged a month or so ago.
That's right, on the plane with the Stormers in Australia.
Another
good man gone.
Thanks, sir.
You said it, Andy.
Here's Richardson, out in front of the charging Nguyenia. Weston battling their way out of their own 22.
It's fine, he was that way.
Looks like Trevorton may have turned it over here.
Yeah.
Here's Richardson. Nguyenia. Nguyenia. Lovely running from him. He's gone for the outside break. It's a good tackle in the end. Still chances here for Trevorton. Not now. Turnover. Oh, might still be a chance. Bauer having to run it from behind his own goal line. Really needed to find touch with that, and instead it comes down into the hands of Hennett, and Hennett takes it back. That's a super tackle coming in from Mtetwa. Now it's driven up by Darren Garlick.
Yeah.
Stuart Shaw making it available.
It's fine. No hands, blue! Advantage.
Nice advantage for coming around offside there. Referee playing a little bit of an advantage for the 14 men, but now he says no, that's a penalty. No, he's gone straight to the pocket. That's another yellow card, this time to Weston.
Hands in. Go.
Wow, Andy, I tell you what, Trevorton, they're impressing me. With 14 men, they've been dominating since their man went off.
Well, it's Mtechwa who is having to leave the field. He played in this game last year, and he hasn't done anything terrible. But the referee did give a warning.
On the body. Okay.
Is there going to be a change here with this check?
Stamp number 13 blue. Where's the mark?
In front of me.
Okay, so we can stay there, though.
Stay there.
Okay, so another guy going to the bin.
Yeah.
Okay. 13. Number 13. Number 13.
This is Wesley Liversidge.
I have a report of a clear boot on a player. You leave the player. Unfortunately for you, that means you go into the bin.
So, this game is really turning around now. We've got three yellow cards.
Okay, you've got two options here. The one penalty is there.
Trevorton, two for Weston.
Okay, cool.
How quickly can things turn around? I mean, a few minutes ago, Trevorton were one player down, and we thought this could go one way, and all of a sudden, it's just changed the other way.
And now they're one player up. So it's up to the supporters to lift their sides.
Hold it. Hold it. Guys, come back. You can't come back. Mark's here. Let's try it again. Come back. Here's your mark. Here's your mark. Here's your mark.
The problem with when you've got players off the field like this, all of a sudden your line-out moves doesn't work as smooth as they used to. Because one player is away. Or
that was well taken by Gometti, though. And here's the drive. Struan and Cowie, he got a try in the first half. Can he get another one here? He's the man on the ball. Desperately trying 16. To get across the line. There's a real chance here for Trevorton. Cowie's over. Referee says he's held up.
Initially held up. Okay.
And if he is held up, that is brilliant defense.
It's very unfortunate from where we were sitting. It looked almost like it could have made it.
It's about 15. Just under 15, sorry.
Very good 13. Drive again, very good set.
It's two to go.
But from here, we can't really see whether that's over or not.
That's right.
Now, Mtechwa is in the sin bin, so they're going to have to bring on a new prop forward. Talking about Weston now. There he is.
Trevorton now. They've got a very good opportunity. They're 5 meters from the line.
No. He's coming.
On the left-hand side of the field, so basically the whole right-hand side of the field is open. They one man up on the opposition.
He's going off. One of you has to go off. A flank has to go off. One of you, just go this side. Just go this side.
Now, coming on for Weston is number 18, Devon Roo.
One of you's off. One of you's off. Let's go. No, you're playing. You're playing. Let's go. It's a prop.
Oh, he's still waiting, I think, for a prop forward who should be Luyanda Tabedi.
Hold on, hold on. Listen. Listen. Listen, come here, listen. Listen. You're on as a prop, right? Are you on? Are you on as a prop?
He's passing a message on.
Okay, who's the prop then?
Okay, he's run all that way to pass a message on.
There you go.
I understand the language, yeah?
His name must be Hermes then, the messenger of the gods.
That was wonderful.
One of you guys?
Luckily, the captain, Michael Barr, came in and just explained what was going on.
Let's go, guys.
Looks to me as if James Muller has gone from flank to tight end prop.
Bond.
Whatever, play continues, and it's Francois Bass to feed the scrum for Trevorton.
Leave it.
Oh, and there's nobody marking that flying winger. He's over the line, but he can't get the ball there. That's fantastic defense. Hennett was held up a meter short. Now, Bass with the little reverse, and that's the try. Beautifully done. Trevorton are back in front.
Very good initial move there by Trevorton. The wing. I'm not sure whether it was the wing.
It's Cowie, the hooker, who's got his second.
And he is absolutely fired up. He's ready for more.
15 and a half, yeah.
Tough little guy. He plays hard. I've been watching him. Yep, that was number 11. Ryan Hennig. I thought he was going to get over there. Just didn't make it. And there goes number 2, Stuart Cowie. And he said, I want more. Bring it.
Conversion is good. And so the lead has changed hands again. 17 points to 13 in favor of Trevorton. And we've got 15 minutes left in this game. Struan Cowie, Scottish name, and of course many Scottish families here in the KwaZulu-Natal Midlands, many of them coming over in the mid-19th century to farm an area that's regarded by many as too cold for farming. But people in Scotland no different.
That was obviously a little bit warm for them.
Kalipa, take the scrum in the middle.
So Bauer has put the ball straight out on the full. What number's that dog wearing? That's a lovely move. Now, I think that Trevorton are now back to 15 men. Just having a look, and I can't see our Lone Ranger standing by the post anymore. That's in touch.
Go. Okay.
Now, this poor chap, Devon O'Brien, has been fighting with that wound on his arm for the entire game.
And the scratch is really just a little scratch. It's not even that big.
Yeah, four. Open. Close.
Open. Louder.
Lulami Lay Karma putting the ball in for Weston. And that's gone against the throw.
Backwards.
Base, though, was sacked. It is still available, though, for Trevorton. Richardson. Ball hanging up in that stiff breeze. And now, out on the right wing is Malando. Gets a round of applause for that. Bauer, good step from the captain and fly Fine half, play. And he's still going. Very difficult to bring down. Makes a good play 15 on. Or so meters there. Now it's taken on by the scrum half, Untombela. Bauer acting at scrum half to the charging Leave flank it. Forward, Dubé. Bauer back in position at fly half, and this is Mustard. What a show from Kyle Mustard. Rumbles towards the line. Held 15 meters short. And just lost it forward. Yes, look at that. Kyle Mustard. He's trying to get the crowd involved.
Kyle is absolutely excited. But I would be as well. It's a wonderful run. Little step on the inside. Shrugs off another tackler.
There's a bit of beef in that Mustard, isn't there?
2.5 times.
I'm sure they use him to move the cattle around. He's a big fella. And he was very happy after that.
There's the local boys trying to cheer their team on. It's a Trevorton confirmation. They are back to 15. Weston down to 13 with two men in the bin. And here's Richardson for Trevorton. That wasn't his best kick. And there's a chance here for Malando. He's done well. And now here's Slow up from fullback. Good delay of the pass. It hasn't gone forward, or has it?
Lost.
The referee says it has.
Michael Bauer, he's really impressed me today. You can see when a player has got that natural skill and ability. He might be someone that Etienne Finn look at and possibly have a future.
So we're heading for the last 10 minutes of the game.
Wait.
Trevorton on the retreat in the scrum. Back to Richardson. Taken by Nkambule. Covered by Devon O'Brien.
Right, no, leave it. Boo! Leave it.
Francois Bass. This is Goumedi. He's had a good game. Gets the flick pass away to Massignano.
Can we release them now, Blue? Yeah, thanks.
Trevorton being pinned in their own half and having to use the boot to get out of it. Good run from Malande. There's another strong drive from Dubay.
Watch.
Weston, they trail by four. We're inside the last 10. Taken up by James Muller.
Come out.
He played for the Falca in the Grant Como week a couple of years ago before relocating to the Midlands.
Missed it, yeah.
All those tackles have been very hard ones indeed. Here's a chance. Brilliant running from Bauer. And he just couldn't grab the ball on the ground there, so advantage being played. Although the advantage was going the way of Weston, and it's a penalty advantage for them. Anton Baylor trying to probe the short side. That's gone forward, and so they'll come back for the penalty. Now, of course, 3 points wouldn't be enough for Weston here.
Well, Andy, something amazing is happening here. We've got Weston with two guys in the bin. They doing all the play. Trevorton once or twice got the ball and they kicked it back to Weston. That's something that I think was wrong. Weston, they should be the guys really suffering and struggling at the moment, but they're showing hard and they're playing amazing rugby.
Trevorton player looking as if he's in a bit of stress here.
Steven, yeah.
No, here's Michael Bauer again.
You are six off his feet.
Wonderful inside-outside step, and he backs it up with pace. In fact, so much pace that he ran away from all his support, and unfortunately, they lost the ball.
Yeah, sure. Go. How's it going here, guys?
It's a good player, Michael. I think we'll see him again in the future.
That's the tight head prop. You wouldn't have seen that a few years ago. Mtetwa waiting to come back from the sin bin with Livicic. When did a tight head prop ever do press-ups?
Never.
For the game, it's six
minutes.
Yeah. Seven, my watch. Yeah.
Well, the sun has dropped behind the hills behind us, and the temperature has plummeted with it.
Decision time, guys. Decision time.
And Andy, as you mentioned before, in school rugby, the time doesn't stop when there's injuries, so this really counts in the favour of Trevorton.
He's certainly not going to be able to continue, and that's a big loss for them because Francois Bass has been one of their standout players. He's, which one's the tight end and which one's the loose head there?
Wait for him to come back. Wait for him to come. It's fine there, wait. Hold on.
Coming on is Canelo Siwe. Here goes Dubay for Weston. Yeah. Weston chasing the game. They trail by five. It's taken on by Mustard. Mustard is forced into touch.
Got it.
wonderful run from Dubai. He's really put his body in the line. He's played his heart out there today. He's given everything he's got. Unfortunately, Mostert could just not stay in field.
He's going off now.
Sorry about the foul, please.
Yeah. Okay. Don't worry, guys. He's playing.
Tackled by one of the backline players.
Important throw this for Stuart Kelly. And that's another good win for Valentino Massignani. Everything to play for in this game. Five and a half minutes to go in this FNB Classic Clash. It was a very one-sided game last year. A half century of points being recorded by Weston. Not this year.
Advantage, yeah.
It's one of the great things about schoolboy rugby is Mora's Nochadach.
Mora's Nochadach, Andy. And Trevorton is really trying to just play out the time at this moment. They set up a good drive from their own try line and they moved about 10 meters up the field. Just playing out the time, hoping to wrap this game up.
Richardson sends it into touch. Hasn't found too much distance though. So both sides back to 15. And everything to play for.
I would imagine that Trevorton would try for the drive again. Winning a bit of time.
And here they go. Carey controlling it at the back. Weston haven't really got enough men behind the ball carrier.
Leave the legs. No.
Good tactics from Trevorton. 4 minutes left in the game. They're just trying to keep possession. Now Carey has got himself isolated. That might well be a penalty. The referee says not. Siwe has lost it forward, though.
That was a very good drive from Trevorton. Control. They were dominating the contact there. Unfortunately, just had the knock on at the end. And Strunkowi had a good game today. He's been really dominating and controlling those driving balls. Fiery, fiery hooker.
Bang! Six!
Bauer floats one up. In fact, it was Bauer on the crash ball there. Good drive from Karma.
No hands, Watts!
Bauer comes in at scrum half, taken on by Dubay. He's been outstanding. Really strong ball carrier. Here's Bauer again, trying to win the game on his own for Weston. Yeah. He's been sacked, but the referee says no problem with that. Trevorton turned the ball over, and their section of the crowd is delighted about that. Siwe sends it back to Richardson, and Richardson picks out Slow. Here goes Slow. Oh, that's a super tackle from Richardson, the man who put the kick in.
What's on the head? What? What? Leave it.
Slow did very well to maintain possession through that tackle. Here's Bauer again. Turnover ball for Trevorton. Siwe has it.
One. Okay, release it, Blue. Blue, no hands.
So some more big hits coming in as this game draws towards its conclusion. Just 90 seconds left now. Trevorton lead by four. They have the ball, and not now they don't. Turned over. Advantage for that knock-on. Little bit of stepping and looking for somebody who wants to carry the ball. That's nicely done. Wesley Liversidge, he's had 10 minutes in the sin bin, and he will have fresh legs.
Okay, wait, what? Yeah. Ball's out of play.
Oh, the ball was out, and it has been regathered by Trevorton now. Pickering has it on the ground.
Oh,
absolute chaos and mayhem.
What a finish to this game. We're inside the last minute. Weston need a try to win it. Trevorton have the ball at the moment. It's not coming out. Where does the referee's allegiance lie here? It's with Trevorton.
I tell you, Andy, it's carnage out there. The last few minutes have been absolutely physical. There were about seven turnovers in the last few sets of play. And these boys all won the victory. Both teams won the victory. All the players are back on the field. There's no sin bins anymore. A few seconds left. And anyone's game it is.
Probably, yes.
Straight out.
Okay.
So the clock is relentlessly turning over, and this should be the last set piece of the game. Kawanelo Seaway to feed the scrum. The referee's not happy.
Get the bind, please. No, get your long on. Get your long bind.
Telling him Tetua where that arm has to go. And Weston choosing that moment to make a change. Coming on is Shilembe. In fact, it's Henry Stradham out on the right wing.
Not so sure why Liversidge got taken off with a few seconds to go.
So Seaway with the feed. They just need to get the ball off the park. They've gone down. The referee is not going to blow the final whistle.
Get that angle. Let's go. Get the angle going straight.
They've started celebrating in the Trevorton ranks.
Cross.
Bind.
Tap on.
Sit.
Seaway has it. Richardson will just get it off the park. He's kicked it all the way back to Moy River. And there it is. Trevorton, what a turnaround for them. They were hammered in this fixture last year, but they've turned it around and they've won today by 17 points to 13. That's what it means to the players and the supporters. What a day, AJ.
Wonderful to see the whole school running onto the field. They are so happy and ecstatic about it. And on the other side, you've got the Weston guys. Fortunately, not their day today. But what a wonderful game to watch in the chilly Moy River area. Absolute joy out there.
Well, you got a feel for the Weston boys on the cameras in their home fixture, in their centenary year, but they brought so much to this game. You really can't criticize either side. There's the captain, Michael Barrett. We'll be speaking to him in just a little while from now. So we'll just go back to the studio briefly. There's the final score in this Classic Clash. Trevorton 17, Weston 13.